ABBYY FlexiCapture Project Setup Station. We'll talk about the Project Setup Station and what items compose a project, what items are embedded in a project. And we'll talk about working with projects and we'll throw in some best practices. So in this diagram, you can see that the Project Setup Station is here, and we're really focused in a pre-production area. So this is really the production workflow that we spoke about earlier, ingestion, recognition, verification, export. Prior to production, we can get into the Project Setup Station and actually build our projects. So a project is a single environment uniting the document batches and the settings required to process them. So a project includes one or more document definitions. A project without any document definitions can't recognize any documents. Optionally, we can have batch types. Those are projects within a project. Image import profiles, such as hot folders, and various project settings, including, say, workflow settings. And then work batches contain the actual images that are verified and exported. And finally, we can have classifiers if we choose to use them. If we don't use classifiers, then we classify documents based on rules. So to create or edit a project, you need to be an administrator. You need to be an administrator to create a brand new project. But if you have the role project setting editors, you can adjust a project, but you just can't create one from scratch. And the basic steps to getting going is to create a brand new project, configure it locally, and then upload it to the application server when you're ready to go into production. You can still edit the document, the project, but you need to open it directly from the server. We'll briefly go over some definition items here. Project structure. So a project may or may not contain batch types. If you create a batch type, it'll contain document definitions, workflow settings, maybe pre-processing settings and classification settings. A document definition has to have a means of identifying a document. And there's also fields that are defined and recognition properties associated with those fields, validation rules, so that we know that the data is clean. And exports are set up at the document definition level. A document definition by default always has an initial section, but it can have additional sections. And that's really important if you've got pages in your document that repeat. If that's the case, then you want to create a separate document section for those repeating pages. And there's a document assembly GUI interface that allows you to set some simple rules. A document section by default has to have at least one page. It can have more than one pages, and we'll have fields for processing. And a field has a set of properties that you can configure so that you get the best recognition results. A batch is a set of scanned documents. So FlexiCapture is a batch-based system. So whenever we're processing documents, they're within a batch. And within that batch, we can have documents and fields. Also here is listed a document set. Now, a document set is optional, but you can set up a document set to specify what the composition of a batch should be, or a set of documents. And that has very flexible rules. So it's a powerful feature. So a batch type is a project within a project. So if I've got human resources documents, and I've also got manufacturing documents in the same project, I'm going to create a batch type for human resources document definitions and another batch type for the manufacturing document definitions. And that achieves a lot. I can make sure that, let's say I've got 15 of each. If I create a batch type for human resources, I'll add only those 15 document definitions for human resources. And then when I process a bunch of images, let's say I'm in the HR department scanning, I'll select the HR batch type, and there's no way that I can match any of the documents that are for manufacturing. They're not included in my batch type. So also security comes along with this. If I'm a HR user, I can't see the manufacturing documents in the project, and vice versa. If I'm a manufacturer employee, I can't see the HR documents. So FlexiCapture working batches are the batches that actually get processed in production. They'll get verified and exported. Test batches are for testing, and you can make a change to a document definition and not publish it and still test those changes using a test batch. We have the ability to create a test copy. Once we've uploaded a project to a server, we may want to maybe test some script, but we don't want to affect our production environment. So we can quickly create a test copy and make and test those changes. And then we've got the ability to either commit or delete that test copy. So if you're happy with your results, you can commit. If you're not happy, you go ahead and delete that test copy. We also have the ability to password protect projects. That can be a good idea. But one thing is, it's very important to know how to export a project. So if you've uploaded a project to the server, the easiest way to back it up is to export it to a local folder and then go ahead and back that local folder up. And a best practice is to open up a batch before you export with the kinds of documents that are representative of that project. Perhaps you may want to send an uploaded project to ABBYY Tech Support. The first step would be to export it to a local folder, zip it up, and then email it. And maybe Tech Support makes some changes to your project. They then email it back to you. You have the ability to ingest their changes. There's an import feature that allows you to take their changes. That's the project update feature. So we quickly covered a lot of important material here. We talked about project properties. We talked about document definitions, a little bit about batch types. And we talked about test batches and the ability to create a test copy of a project. We also talked about exporting projects.